Hello guys, and welcome to this tutorial video from biology slideshow. In this video we will talk about two-dimension electrophoresis, which is a technique to separate and purify proteins and also to study the total proteome profile of biological sample. So first of all, this technique combined between two methods of protein separation. One is isoelectric focusing and the other one is SDS page. And we're not able to go in details about each of these techniques. So my channel provides a separate video for each of these techniques. So I highly recommend you to watch those videos and then to complete this video. First of all, SDS page, which is the traditional method for protein separation, it is molecular weight based protein electrophoresis, and also known as one dimension protein electrophoresis, because as you know, it's vertical gel electrophoresis, and also it depends on only one parameter for proteins separation, which is molecular weight. But there is some drawback in this technique. One of these is related to separate or purify the protein precisely, because when there are some proteins have same or similar molecular weight, there is no way to separate them based on SDS page. For that, we might need additional parameter for protein separation to purify each of them. In this case, we might use two-dimension electrophoresis technique. Two-dimension electrophoresis is a powerful technique for protein separation and, as I said, studying the proteome profile of biological sample. And also, it depends on two basic steps. First of all, separation of protein based on their isoelectric points by using isoelectric focusing technique, and the second phase is separation of proteins based on their molecular weights by using SDS page technique. Those are the major steps of two-dimension electrophoresis. So first of all, we should prepare the sample. In this step, we should extract the proteins, and also we should maintain their native charge, solubility, and their relative abundance. And also we should prevent any chemical modifications and remove any chemical substances that can interfere with the electrophoresis or separation process. For example, like salts and detergents. So after protein extraction, we should quantify those proteins. We should use some quantification method like Lowry method or Pratt for the say. After that, we should do the rehydration. Rehydration means to make the proteins immobilized to IPG strip. So in this case, we use a rehydration buffer, which contains the following components: ammopholytes, which maintain the pH and helps to solubilize the proteins; urea or thiourea, which disrupt the hydrogen bonds and hydrophobic interactions between and within the proteins and increase the protein solubility; chaps also disrupt the interaction within and between proteins; and DTT, which is a reducing agent that reduce the disulfide bonds within the proteins. As you know, the proteins are amphoteric molecules, which means that they can take positive, negative, or even neutral charge based on the pH of the surrounding environment. The pH in which that certain protein becomes neutral in charge or having zero net charge is called isoelectric point for that protein. So in this case, the carboxylic groups will be negatively charged and amino groups will be positively charged, and this is called isoelectric point. when the pH of the surrounding environment is lower than isoelectric point for this protein, the protein takes the positive charge because of the amino group will take protons from the surrounding environment. And on the other hand, when that pH environment is more alkaline, the carboxylic group will be negatively charged and the protein will take the negative charge as a whole. So when the proteins are subjected to the pH gradient of IPG strip, they will take negative, positive, and neutral charge depending on their position on the IPG strip. In this figure, the proteins are immobilized to the IPG strip. Each circle presents a different protein. The size of the circle represents the molecular weight of that protein, and the color represents isoelectric point of that protein. Subject those proteins to an electric field, which make them move on the opposite direction for their charge. Negatively charged proteins will move to the acidic pool of the IPG strips and vice versa. During the motion of proteins, they either pick protons or lose protons until their net charge is equal to zero. This is known as isoelectric point. In this case, they will stop of moving. So by this, we can separate the proteins based on their isoelectric points. So equilibration is the second step. And in this case, we add reducing agents like DTT to disrupt the disulfide bonds within the proteins and to prevent those disulfide bonds from reforming. We add iodoacetamide as alkylation agent, and also we treat the proteins with SDS, which provides the proteins with negative charge in the same mass to charge ratio, so they will be separated only based on their molecular weights. And also it stratify the peptide chains of the proteins. So by this step, the proteins will be ready for the next phase of gel electrophoresis, which is SDS page. As you know, SDS page is vertical electrophoresis, but there are some points I would like to draw your attention to it, and the difference between this SDS page applied in 2DE and traditional SDS page. In this case, we don't use stacking gel. You might know that the purpose of stacking gel is to make the proteins enter the resolving gel at the same point of the time. But in this case, as they are already immobilized to IPG strip, there is no need for stacking phase of the gel. The other point is that the comp we use in 2DE is a little bit different from that used in case of SDS page. In the case of 2DE, we have two wheels, one bigger for the IPG strip and one small for the marker, because marker is complex of known weight proteins. So we use them to identify the molecular weights of different proteins. The second step of two-dimensional electrophoresis is SDS page, as we said. Those proteins will be separated according to their molecular weights, because SDS will give the whole proteins negative charge in the same mass to charge ratio. So the molecular weight is the only factor to be considered. And hence the proteins will be separated in two parameters: on x-axis based on their isoelectric points, and on y-axis based on their molecular weights. And the 2DE gel provides a nice photo about the proteome profile of our biological sample. That was everything. Thank you for watching.